Hello, I'm Mr. Arnachary, retired lecturer in Metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. So, I studied the New Testament in 1982, and immediately I understood it, because it was simpler than the holy books of the Sikhs, which is more difficult. So Christianity is a stepping stone to Sikhism. A person who does not understand the gospel of the first anointed Christ, Jesus, he cannot understand the gospel of the second coming of Jesus in the name of Nanak, who appeared in the Punjab in 1469. And he preached gospel through five more lives, in total six of them, to perfection. And each Satguru, which stands for Christ, had a specialization, and they prepared the Sikhs from the root to the finishing touch. Whereas Jesus prepared his workers. Jesus had no disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline a natural boys, 12 to 16 years old, by teaching them the moral law of Moses. So rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, John the Baptist, they had disciples, and they used to pray and fast. As stressed in when Jesus was eating at Matthew's place, some Pharisees, Sadducees came, "Hey, your disciples don't wash their hands before eating, or don't say prayer and fasting?" That is a proof, you know, because in Jesus, when we are twice born, our Father is inside us. And that is called Emmanuel, because this is the temple of God. God is inside us. If you don't go out of the way, everything that you speak should be logical. And logical reasoning, brew logo, which is his word. So people write books for the sake of money, to make money. And they give sugar-coated sermon, and they are very happy to address Jesus as Lord. Lord has slaves. In Jesus we have one Father, and we are all brethren. Yahweh is the Lord of creation. So in his seat are sitting these, Prophet Elijah was sitting in his seat. And so are the rabbis and Pharisees, Sadducees. So they are the Lord, and not in Jesus. We are brethren. Slaves are not allowed into the house. Sons are allowed. That's why when parable of 10 virgins, 5 went in, knocked at the door, said, "Abba, Abba." Father said, "Come in, sons." The other 5 psychic wanted to praise him, you know, to boost his ego, but he can't be praised by false addresses like Lord, Lord. And they went there called addressing our Father, "Lord, Lord, Lord." He said, "Oi, I set people free. I don't enslave people. Get lost." He kicked them away. So this is the way in the Bible, it has been altered by the Messianic Jews. They have introduced the word disciple and Lord and all that same. You have to be careful when you read it. So today I went to Oxford University in Manchester College, Manchester Harris they call it, and there was a book launch by my old friend and brother Richard Harris. He is known as the Right Reverend the Lord Harris of Pentregarth, Doctor of Divinity. He is a Lord in the House of Parliament. So he launched in Christ, about Christ, you know, he launched the book. So I wanted to know whether he understood Jesus, which you can see with two naked eyes. Then only you will be able to perceive Christ in him. If you can't know Jesus, you cannot know Christ. As simple as that. He had written a book on Christ. So I asked him a question, you know, that Jesus' Hebrew name is Yahshua. I want to know the two components of his name. And he did answer, I'm a bit deaf, you know, being old age. I didn't grasp everything, but however, I thought I would go home and make a video. And that's what I'm going to make, a YouTube video. I was at Oxford University on your book launch. I'm addressing this video to my brother Richard Harris. I was at Oxford on your book launch at Manchester Harris College. And it was well attended. The church building was, you know, church over there was almost full, you know, 95% full. Quite a big attendance. I think I first met you at King's College around, say, 1985 or so, when I came from Ghana in 1983. And so I went, wrote articles, and then I went to see people in theology and King's College. I think he was the dean over there. I was in Ghana as a lecturer in metallurgy for 14 years. And my father knew this subject of religion. He died over there in 1980. And in his honor, I wrote the exposition of Matthew in 1982. It was written in Holy Spirit, which is common sense, called Surti in Punjabi. Excuse me. You know, when people write articles, they always get a collection. This man says so, this man says so, that man says, then they summarize it. And what about him? He doesn't know anything. That is called book knowledge. And book knowledge make you super donkey carrying holy books. And book knowledge is old wine. If once you get drunk with the old wine, you desireth not the new. So if you want new wine, then you have to cleanse your stomach or cleanse your wine skin to contain the new wine. And that is how Jesus prepared at Cana, the stone vat stone vat, he told them to rinse every speck of old wine. And after rinsing, they put clean water, that was the heart of a little child. And with the Holy Spirit as the yeast, then the new wine was brewed. So I have our videos on that topic and every topic, because over 6,600 videos I have on YouTube. If somebody is interested to go deeper. So Holy Spirit, common sense called Surti and Punjabi, men of letters, did not appreciate, except a Baptist minister in Hemel Hampstead, Reverend. He was a scientist, you know, BSc, Reverend. He was Edwin Robertson, who has written many books. I wrote the exposition of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman at well, and they are well known in India, those five husbands. And I used to send that article to everyone which I find in the newspaper. I will go in the library, look for people who are religious, religious views, and I happened to send one to this man, Edwin Robertson, and he responded. He went to the Hayford College in London. Over there he was teaching them, you know. And he told the theologian that, hey, I have found the names of the five husbands. And he responded that they were very happy, but I don't know. But no reaction, because gospel is by grace. Nobody can have it unless our Father giveth. That's why Peter could not have gospel. Even he was with Jesus all the time, except at one time when he said, you are the Messiah of living God. Then Jesus stressed, soul and flesh does not give you this knowledge, except by the grace you get Holy Spirit, common sense, and then you receive this knowledge. Common sense called common is not so common. I was speaking to a barista in Sona. I used in a health club, Sona. A barista came to join us in the Sona. I asked him, Holy Spirit is common sense. He said, common sense is not so common. In the courts, they use dead letters. They go by this law, that law. They don't use common sense. So, however, let's carry on. So, Edwin Robertson, he has written over almost 100 books, you know. He was a good writer. Now I ask you a very basic question. I asked him over there in the Oxford, a very basic question on Christianity. St. Thomas went to India and people addressed him as Christ, Thomas. And Pope came there, he said, one Christ, Jesus only, don't call Thomas a Christ. So he burned the books and killed the people who are known as Christ. So were his brethren called Christ and not Christians of the book. I too am a Christ of Holy Spirit. Christians are the people of the book. The book knowledge is milk. Milk you gulp without thinking or without chewing it. That is gulped milk. So, for example, John the Baptist said, I am baptizing in water. The one coming after me will baptize in Holy Spirit. Now, when these people in the churches, they baptize somebody, They baptize him in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, or Holy Spirit. They don't understand the difference between the two. So he did not do it like that. So what a type of baptism is this in the churches? It's not what John the Baptist did. So I asked them, then he said, John the Baptist, when Christ come, he will give you the baptism in Holy Spirit. I'm baptizing in water. The one coming after me will baptize you in Holy Spirit. So in whose name John the Baptist baptized the Jewish men only? He never baptized a Gentile or a woman or a Samaritan. And university professors, they don't want to know this one. Why? So milk is God. Christ live on the juicy meat of Jesus, which you can't gulp, you have to chew it with the teeth of logical reasoning, which are dwelt in the twice born people. Once born people do not have teeth. They just gulp like babies. So twice born people then have this juicy meat of Jesus as our daily bread of life. That's why Jesus said, you know, he's a true vine planted by our Father in the vineyard, to which we must graft ourselves. And that vineyard is inside the narrow gate. So here you are. This is the John the Baptist baptizing in the name of Abraham, Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father, Yahweh. Then those who are sons of man, they enter this solitary narrow gate into the royal kingdom of God. Here they burn their ego of flesh. Because supernatural Father, whether you are male or female, is the same soul in both of us, black or brown. So there you exercise agape, unconditional love. We have a big family then, not a small one. Well, like the once born people, they are racist. They only know this one, not the supernatural, natural only. Now, our elder brother Christ Thomas said, first know what you see with your two naked eyes, naked natural eyes, then what is not seen but perceived by the third eye of logical reasoning would be known to you. That means Christ is known to you by the third eye of logical reasoning. But first you must know what you see with your two naked eyes, natural eyes. That is what Christ Jesus said. Those in the Jerusalem, you know, those theologians of the Jerusalem, they will see with the two naked eye, but not perceive. Or they will see, read books, you know, letters. You can see the letters, you can read it and vomit them out, as in the university they do it today. The read books are scriptures, but they will not perceive. Perceive means the roots in oral Torah, or his word called logo. So oral Torah is his word. The root of the moral law lies in that one. It's like a tree. Moral law is a tree. The root of the tree are oral Torah. So if you do not know the oral Torah, you are not well versed with the oral Torah, then the tree is dead tree. So That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead, as they do it in the universities. Here is why Jesus was named Yahshua. That was our main question, or the components of the word Yahshua, Yahweh. There are two components of this word. One is Yah, which stands for Yahweh, equal to Brahma in Punjabi we call it, and Khuda in Arabic. The demiurge, creator of male and female parts. This is a part, you know. The soul inside is of our supernatural father. Parts are nature at large, into which the soul of our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., is infused to make the parts living, to make this part living. Without soul, it's dead. So our soul is a supernatural component. And this is natural component. So you can't see the supernatural. You have to perceive supernatural. Natural you can see with the two natural eyes. The second component is Shiva, or equal to Shiva we call him, the primal Adam. Thus Mary was sired by Yahweh, and Jesus was the second Adam, with Mary as the surrogate mother and Joseph of Judah tribe in the line of King David, the foster father. That is why Jesus always addressed Mary as a woman and not mother. It was at the cross Jesus addressed Mary as mother to stress that, look, what your people of Judah tribe have done, Judah tribe who had become Jew outwardly, and thus the tears, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, have done to me. So to stress that one, you know, that Jesus called her mother. But she was not his mother, but surrogate mother. People can alter what is written, you know, but the one you receive by Holy Spirit, direct from God, is a gospel, is brand new cloth, untouched by human hand. That is why it's called Oral Torah. It cannot be written down in ink on paper, but get written over your heart if you do the logical reasoning. I can't do it for you. If you want gospel, you have to do logical reasoning yourself. So, who had become Jew outwardly, thus the tears, Matthew 13, have done to me. Jew is a spiritual self and not the physical self that is born and dies. Physical self, natural self is born and natural self dies. Supernatural self, soul, is never born, never die. It is emanated from our Father and it returns back to Him. Thus it was Jesus who died on the cross and not Christ. Jesus rose on the third day and not Christ, which stands for His word, equal to fountain of the Oral Torah, who came to fulfill the law, Matthew 13 verse 52, defined where the ideal rabbi is defined. He is the owner of a house who bringeth forth treasures, old and new. Old is scripture and new is Oral Torah, which was missing among the Jewish people. Samaritan rabbis, they had the knowledge of the Oral Torah. They were the generation of Joseph, whom the other 11 crook brother sold him as slave to Egyptian. Yeshua also and explicit proof of the virgin birth of Jesus, in that his father was Yahweh, and not any tribal father, not any person, but Yahweh. That is why he made a whip to throw the traitors out of the house of his heavenly father, Yahweh, who is jealous and revengeful, a jealous and revengeful father. The supernatural father of Christ, Christ is in the heart. Not this one is not Christ. Christ is title in one heart, quality. Christ, Elohim, being all loving and merciful, we present the other cheek instead of hitting the person back. Much more in my other videos, and hope it conveys my message that first know Jesus, then Christ will be known to you, and you can write books as many as you like from your own heart. Our Father God, bless you.